Hello, blah 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 blahs blah. Isn't it Bob blah blah's blog? Blah blahs. Anyway, low blah slaw ka. Oh, I thought it was Bob blah blah from Arrested Development, but no. Anyway, okay. This post didn't really show or explain it all that well. You essentially mean to create the whole left pad debacle, where you're not writing code but just chaining together a bunch of libraries and functions that I assume are written by LLMs. That sounds absolutely horrible. Or am I misunderstanding? Luckily, you're misunderstanding. Where do we start? We'll start with, all right, so we have a stack here called PPS, particles, parsers, and scroll. And so let's take a traditional programming language. Let's go to, I don't know, let's do something harder. Take Haskell. All right. So, actually, we don't have any good examples there. Well, let's just take Python. I need something. Let me give me something with a. All right, we'll take this. What's this, Java? All right, so Java parser is going to take this whole program, generate abstract syntax tree, in it from a top-down way. You're going to have the parser, the Lexer compiler, etc. We're all going to. It's going to be one monolith. Thing's going to read the program in and turn it to byte code and machine code and execute the thing. So with a programming language designed for microprogramming, the design is a bit different. Let me show you. Let's take news.pub. This is a builder news. It's like Hacker News except more positive place. And let's look at that home page. Index.scroll. All right. So a simple example. Let me copy this. Let's get some syntax highlighting. So let me go to try.scroll. Yeah, let me do a new incognito window. All right. So basically, think of this as this whole program can be split into what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I'm going to skip the blank lines, but 14 microprograms. And now those can all be parsed in parallel by their own parsers. And we do that to various degrees depending upon what the task is. Instead of just saying this is one monolithic program, you could treat this as 14 little microprograms. And so they get parsed and then they go into. We've got a little animation to kind of show this. So things become particles and then you have parsers that join to each particle. This is actually slightly inaccurate. I gotta fix this because it's really about lines. Lines are becoming particles. So lines are, we call them particles. AKA microprograms, and they get joined by parsers. So we have a title parser, we have a view source URL parser. This is an import parser that's picking up on the. So parsers can have either keywords can match on keywords or they can match on regular expressions. So this is the table parser. So there are a few different strategies that parsers can map on, but basically a parser binds to every single microprogram here or particle, and then we can do what we want with those bound things. So in this case, if we look up that, let's look at what's in this header file here. I'm just going to go ahead and copy this. And paste this, and that's all that happens under the hood is basically a copy paste when you do a header, and we can, just so we can see that. So we have some CSS here. We'll just take this out for now. I mean, it's pretty straightforward. This is going to compile to CSS. what I wanted to show here is these build text and build HTML microprograms. So these get picked up by the build text parser, the build HTML parser. And so when this guy's present, it's gonna run a compilation of this whole program and generate a text file. And when this guy's present, it's gonna run a compilation of the whole program and generate an HTML file. And so the outputs of all of these, so like the say, where's the, okay, like this is just a quick paragraph. It just outputs plain text. So this is just gonna output plain text in this file, but it's also gonna output HTML with this guy. So this guy kind of interacts with all these other particles. Think of it like a petri dish of different parsers and microprograms, and you put them all together. Sometimes order is important depending on what kind of microprogram it is. Sometimes it's not. You know, if you're compiling to HTML, well, of course you want the order is going to be important. You're going to want to put the stuff up top. So what else? I mean, this is fucking great. This is one of the most useful things. You could just throw a HTML file name in there, and it's going to import that HTML as is, right directly there. Same goes for CSS, I think. I don't know if we import the CSS or no. I think we'll for this. I think we do by default. We do a link tag. And same for JavaScript, we do, and we'll insert a script tag to include that file. But for HTML, we're actually going to grab that HTML. I'm sorry, for HTML, this guy is actually going to grab that HTML and include it. Very useful, especially with LLMs. You can have them write some HTML, stick it in a file, don't muddy your own stuff with that LLM slop, and just include the file like this. All right, so now we have a more complicated microprogram right here, and this is the table one. And so this is importing a CSV file, loading it into a data table. Think of like dplyr and R, and then we have data flow. So then, you know, I rename a column to this, and I select a certain number of columns. I rename another column. I order by rank. I group by rank. I do some reductions, and then I print the result. I can also do data visualizations. We got scatter plots, and we've got heatrixes, and where's heatrix? Sorry, with an H. Oh my God, I can't type. So lots of data viz that you can do. Sparklines, I think. Do you have sparklines? Yeah. And anyway, where was I? So that's a pretty straightforward example. But let's go ahead and. Show a more complicated example. So I'm just going to create a new site right here, random new site, and let's say I want to create my own parser. So I want to say, let's make a parser that, what was your name again? Blah blah blah, Bob, la la, FAQ parser. And now we'll say crux. If I write the word Bob, I want you to match this guy. And then I'm just gonna do a simple thing right now. And I'm not gonna explain too much the language I'm writing now is called parsers. And so I can throw some JavaScript in here. It's not, you know, we can't bootstrap everything immediately. So we need a little bit of glue at the moment. Okay, now when I write the word Bob, I want to say, Bob, la, 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 whatever. This is just a real dumb example. And then I can write the word Bob. And we don't, at the moment, update the syntax highlighting on demand, but, extends. And this should be auto-completed, but it's not for... reason I know what it is, but so there we go. You can see the live preview. So we've just extended the language. So this is a micro program that extends the language, and then we use that down here. So, or you could call it, I mean, people are like, isn't this just functions, whatever? Call it whatever you want to call it. It's fucking simpler. It's done better, okay? Sure, it's a function with zero parameters, or you know, but it could even take parameters. We could do atoms, and we could say, how about this? Atoms, let's do any atom, and then let's do a integer atom, or is it, God, I need to get that autocomplete fixed. And then let's do this. Blah blah. How about this? Blah plus law plus repeat and something like this. Parse int this get atom atoms one. Let's see if that works. 10, 1, 100, and we'll make some space between these. Let's put some bigger spaces between these guys. Okay, so you can see these, you call these functions, but really it's just parsers, just little microprograms. Yeah, sorry, this is long-winded. I don't know if that helps or not, but that's it. If you like this stuff, give us a follow on whatever. Star some of these things. We've got Scroll, we got Scroll Hub, which you just saw. Check out the Worldwide Scroll. Buy a scroll name. If you've watched this far, I'm gonna give you a little secret. You can add a promo code. Thought. Add that promo. Give that promo code a try. Could be quite a nice discount. Get your name on the scroll. But you might not be ready for that. Just try it out. Try out Scroll Hub. Launch a couple sites. Download it to your local machine. We've got join. Oh, we've got a subreddit. Join the subreddit, the Worldwide Scroll subreddit. We've got documentation. Look at the lead sheets with all the parsers that you can use. There's also, so this is the scroll lead sheet. Here is the particles lead sheet. It tells you how everything's broken into particles, atoms, which are just words, and subparticles, which are just indented lines. That's it. That's all the particles is. And then we've got parsers, which is about 30 parsers. And that's what Scroll is written in. And of course, Scroll is, lets you do so many things. It's got a huge standard library. But that's it. It's a new way to program. We've got a book. Get the book. It's going to be public domain at some point, but right now you can, for early source, you can buy it if you want. We just need to, you know, we need to find a sustainable, some sustainable revenue sources to build this thing, because I've funded this thing for over a decade, and it's been quite all my money pretty much. But it's awesome, and it's worth so worth it. And this now it's getting to the fun part, because now you can actually use the damn thing, and it's great, and I love it, and I think you're gonna love it too. Keep asking your questions. I appreciate the time, and no, it's not left pad. All right, have a great day. Cheers.